Lawrence, at last. Oh, the way you've been avoiding my calls, anyone would think I was your mother. This isn't your mother, by the way. Well, unless there's been a horrendous mix-up with the time fracture. But I think you're not Lawrence, which means Lawrence is still missing. Okay, I've not got long, so just listen. I've a funny feeling an old friend of mine made sure this phone fell into your hands, which means you're the right person for the job. The job being, find Lawrence. I can't stress how important that is. Think yellow highlighter and circled in red several times. Yes, that important. Right, my friends call me Petronella. You can call me Osgood. I'm an investigator, looking into the odd, the unexplained, anything on Earth or even beyond. And I've only just realised what a massive remit that is. No wonder I need your help. You and me are going to sift through clues, codes, and face some terrifying enemies. Sound like fun? Look, gotta go. But I'll be in touch, because you and me, we've got a game.
Oh my god, I'm so sorry, man. I just got back and Dazza told me about Nat. You must be like crazy worried. But she's gonna turn up. You probably thought I was well out of order with my texts about the party. But obviously, I'll take care of all that. You need to focus on finding Nat. And hey, I'm here for you, Loz. Whatever you need. Even if it's just to talk. Don't be one of those dinosaurs who thinks talking about problems a mug's game. It helps, man. I should know. Listen, I'm gonna give you another bell later, okay? And we'll find her, yeah? You and her, you're gonna be together forever. Alright, later. Hey, Sally. I know it's been a while, but this is urgent. Nat's missing. It's like she just up and disappeared. It's them, Sal. I know it. They did this. I was... Sorry. What was I thinking? It's just... You're the only one that gets it. You were right to escape.
Shark 1747. Shark 1747. Shark 1747. Shark 1747. Shark 1747.
I said three sugars, you absolute Mr. Nightingale, my dear chap, how did it get to this? I will tell you how it got to this, Nightingale. Your insane crusade to try to stop me carrying out renovations in my cellar. Now, most people know me as an easygoing man who...
Thank you.
For God's sake, make a fresh cup and get it right this time, you glistening simpleton. An easygoing man who prefers to find common ground. But in this case, the only grounds in question belong to me. Wester Drumlins is mine to do with as I wish, and I intend to open up its cellars, attempt to coerce or scare me again, and I shall contact both my lawyers and the police. Actually, I rather think the boys in blue would be fascinated by your tales of killer statues, might even get you committed. And if you think you could remain silent when they pull you in for questioning, the chief constable is an old golfing friend of mine. He'd make you sing, Nightingale. He'd make you sing. I so enjoyed our little chat. Toodle pip.
Watcher 9, 3, 2, 7.
Mr. Nightingale, Lawrence, Larry. I was devastated to hear about your wife, Natalie, I believe her name is, or was. But it does rather prove my point, that you should end your fixation with my property, Wester Drumlins. I've been a patient man, Larry. Throughout all your scaremongering and, let's be frank, your threats. But I've instructed my lawyers, Derbyshire and Mills, to seek a restraining order against you. Your obsession with my property must cease forthwith. That's just something you have to face. Incidentally, my contractors have reported seeing a figure on the grounds of WD on several occasions. I think we both know it's you. Naughty, naughty. So I've upgraded the property security, and you would be ill-advised to go on another one of your snooping expeditions. Call it a day, Mr. Nightingale. It is over. I don't want you within a stone's throw of Wester Drumlins.
Thank you. You have reached the Metropolitan Archive, your one-stop access point to our nation's history. If you are looking for an introduction to the Met Archive, please press 1. For general inquiries, please press 2. For research assistance, please press 3. For international collaborations, please press 4. To return to this menu at any time, press 0. Welcome to the Metropolitan Archive. Our vast library of content comprises items donated by both public and private contributors. We're proud to say it represents one of the largest archives of historical documents, media, and ephemera in the country. If you're just getting started, try browsing through the online catalogue or visiting the archive itself. If you can't find what you're looking for, please feel free to speak to one of our records administrators or make an appointment to visit our offices. If you are looking for an introduction to the Met Archive, please press 1. For general inquiries, please press 2. For research assistance, please press 3. For international collaborations, having trouble finding what you're looking for? Feel free to submit a request or query and one of our administrative staff will get back to you. If you've already made a request or have a search in progress and you'd like to make a call following this up, please dial the 4-digit extension number of the person you would like to speak to after the tone. Otherwise, press 0 to return to the main menu. You have dialed the extension number of Quincy, Marguerite. Please hold while we try to connect you. Hello, Marguerite speaking, records administrator. How may I help you? Hello? Hello?
The line seems to be off or something.
Give me a moment. I have your number right here. Text you in a bit.
Thanks, Henry. This is a message for Lawrence Nightingale of London, England. There should be more instructions attached to the real tin. Hi, Larry. It's so nice to be able to say that again. I'm in Kansas, 1928, the day Herbert Hoover wins the US election, though no one knows that yet. I'm staying at the old Denslow farm, which is lovely and full of great people, and God, I miss you so much. Every single day. I mean, I'm fine. Don't worry. One minute I was in London, my time, our time. The next second, I'm in Times Square, 1926,
It was like life on Mars without John Sim. Oops. He was so great in that. But people only remember Philip Glenister because Gene Hunt was so... I really miss our endless stupid talks about telly. That was always our thing. You better not be schlepping round conventions with someone else now, by the way. Unless it's Sally. Sally. Could you move it closer, please? I know it sounds stupid, but I was always jealous of the thing you two had. I mean, the angel thing. But that's not why I finally snuck off to Wester Drumlins. Honestly, I was trying to help. I don't know how, but... Anyway, as I was leaving, that was when this, like, damaged statue touched me and... Zap. You think Wi-Fi's rubbish in our bedroom? Try 1928. I'm sorry I didn't believe you when you told me how dangerous it was. I pawned all the jewellery I was wearing, made some pretty shrewd moves in the markets. Always knew my degree in American history would come in useful. Call me Natasha Gecko. Actually, don't. Makes me sound like your pet lizard. Did I mention that I miss you? Every single day. Oh, not all my jewellery. The ring of bling. Till death us do part. The vicar didn't mention anything about weeping angels. Henry, what's wrong?
Okay. Captain's log, stardate 54274.7. This is an audio diary. No, it's not. It's an audio journal. Journal always sounds more grown up. Okay. And I'm going to be recording stuff about Wester Drumlins and the angels in case... Well, just in case anyone ever needs to know. Started back in 2005. Long story short, a house... called Wester Drumlins has something nasty in the basement. Creatures called Weeping Angels, or Lonely Assassins, who, if they touch you, will send you back in time to feed off the resultant time energy. And no, I don't fully understand it myself, but they're like stone killers. And the only way to stop them is to look at them. Sounds easy, but it isn't.
I'm home!
Hiya! But it isn't. The angels of Wester Drumlins are trapped in a circle. They're locked together because they're looking at each other. And the cellar is boarded up, so...
Trisha says she's calling the kid Marta.
What's wrong with that?
Marta Carter. What are you doing?
An audio journal.
Did Did you start by saying Captain's Lock, Stardate, whatever?
No.
Did you?
I have done.
Good job, I love you, Mr. Nightingale. Come on, you can give me a hand with the shopping.
Be with you in a tick. Anyway, some guy called Flint has just bought Wester Drumlins. I don't know him, but...
There's a load of frozen stuff needs sticking in the freezer.
On it. I'm sure he won't be a problem. Journal update. Flint is an idiot. I don't mind idiots. I'm used to them. I worked in local government for 6 months, but he's a dangerous idiot. He listened to everything I had to say, didn't believe a word of it. And he said he couldn't guarantee he wouldn't crack on with his plans to renovate the cellar. This guy could unleash the weeping angel.
Which guy?
Hiya. Sorry, didn't hear you coming.
Who are you talking about?
Flint, new owner of Wester Drumlins. He's doing work on the place, which could, you know...
Well, he could be thinking about it. Then see how much decent builders cost and decide he doesn't need a second mortgage. Are you sure?
I'm sure. Ish.
Why don't you go over and check it out? See if he's got any contractors on the job.
I know. I should do. But that place...
Yeah, I know. Look, I'll stick the kettle on.
Nats.
Yeah?
Thanks. I'm praying I can convince Flint not to renovate the lower floors because those steps don't just lead to the cellar. They lead to hell. So, no word from Nat since she popped out last night. I phoned all her mates, no joy. But I can't help thinking... I just wanted to hear her voice. So I played back a couple of my journal entries. One's where she came in, so I'd recorded what she was saying. God. And in one of them, she says I should check out Wester Drumlins. And I say something like, I know, but I don't want to. Well, what if she wanted to help and she went over there to check it out? What if that's what happened? And an angel or something? What if she's gone forever? And I'm responsible?
Just watched the message from Nats. I thought, like an idiot, it would bring us closer, but just made me realise how far apart we are. And how much I miss her, and she's confirmed it. There's at least one active angel at Wester Drumlins. And what with everything that's going on there, I can't wait anymore. I've got to at least try and stop it before it unlocks the others. I know full well it might kill me. Or send me back in time, or... I don't know, maybe I don't stand a chance, but... Last time, me, Sally and the Doctor used their own gazes to lock them in stone. And so, like Perseus, I go into battle with a reflective surface. Doubt I could get hold of a shield, but I'm guessing a mirror will do the trick. The Doctor used to call them the Lonely Assassins. He reckoned it was because they turned to stone if you even glance at them. But if you think about it, lonely assassins are the best kind. Because we've got nothing to lose. Well, this is it. I'm going back to where it all began. Wester Drumlins. Almost there now. It's funny, I've been there dozens of times and always got a tight knot of fear in my stomach. This time though, nothing. I might stop the angels or... Ranny told me about this bloke called Anthony Williams. She interviewed him and he claimed that his parents were zapped by the angels separately, but both ended up in exactly the same point in time and space. So who knows? I might beat the angels forever or have a date at the hot old... Thought so. Right, gotta go. Gonna get in through this side entrance. If I don't make it and you find these messages, you know the drill. Don't turn your back. Don't look away and don't blink. Good luck, Larry.
Aisha, can you hear me?
Loud and clear. I was going to phone you. Are you streaming my body cam feed?
Where are you? Right now.
Scooby-Doo's house.
What?
Wester Drumlins. I just finished installing the exterior cameras. I've done some of the inside ones, but I still need to...
You have to get out of there now.
I was a unit operative for 5 years. I think I can handle a spooky old house. Hey, do you know that there's a statue of the owner in the basement?
Aisha.
Still here.
That isn't statue. Listen to me. You're going to be okay. Just don't...
She was going to say, don't blink.
Who is that? Who are you?
Uh-oh. Wrong question.
What's the right question?
Where are you?
Where are you?
He's behind you. And when your friend said that you shouldn't blink and you're going to be okay, she was only half right.
Flint, yeah? I have some excellent news for you. Something that'll put a smile on your face.
I am dead. Or as good as. The angels are using Flint's consciousness to communicate. Because we wanted to say thank you for being so slow and so incompetent. You couldn't even stop Flint's work on Wester Drumlins. That work has allowed one of our number to free the angels trapped in the cellar. They're regaining their strength, and very soon they will be as right as rain. Your planet will become our larder. And I wanted you to know I will not forget how you tried to stop us. I will find you and send you back to a time when Earth was devoid of life. That shall be your eternal prison. Just think of me as your guardian angel. See you soon.
Aisha. Aisha! Please be okay. Please be... okay.
Angels feast on your friend. You sent her here, Petronella. Glad she's dead. Are you jealous of her as well?
I would only wish death on my worst enemy.
We're growing stronger. Almost ready.
And unfortunately for you, you're my worst enemy.
What's the time, Mrs. Wolf?
I need to get something from outside the house, but I'm afraid... actually, I could just leave it there.
Petronella goes to Hella.
I'm afraid you're going to have to guide me out of here.
Joker 9226.
on, come on, come on. Larry, I love you. The doctor once said that courage isn't just about not being frightened. It's being afraid and doing what you have to do anyway, which is good to know because right now I am very, very afraid. But we have to do this. Okay. I'm in. Oh, why is it always the cellar? Oh, cellar. From the Latin, solarium, meaning the place where monsters hide. Oh, God, it's not really. Sorry. Distraction technique. It's a habit I got off the doctor. Trouble is, it never works.
Petronella goes to Hella. Petronella goes to Hella.
If you're trying to scare me, you're doing a terrific job.
Still jealous of your sister, little girl, with her good looks and charm.
She's no angel, which is why I actually quite like her.
Oh, you've been around time travel machinery, haven't you, Petronella?
She likes to go out, though. Nightclubs, bars.
Lots of yummy Artron energy on you.
I'm more of a library girl myself, but we did go to the odd disco together.
Artron energy makes angels nice and strong.
Never liked the loud music.
Strong enough to.
But I always loved...
Consume your world.
My phone! I think we just saved the planet with a disco ball. Oh, that is so the Doctor.
I said three sugars, you absolute imbe... Mr. Nightingale, my dear chap, how did it get to this? I will tell you how it got to this, Nightingale. Your insane crusade to try to stop me carrying out renovations in my cellar. Now, most people...
It's the doctor. Don't worry. Not your doctor. The doctor. Phoning to say thanks for the work he did with Osgood. Top stuff. You were brave and dogged and whip smart and all those other words people normally use about me. Whoa! Sorry about that. Okay, Osgood's busy overseeing the cleanup operation, but she wanted you to know they're moving the angels from the basement to a top secret cell in the Black Archives. And if you were worried about Mr. Flint, don't be. Got to him in time, and he's making a full recovery. He might still have a heart of stone, but the rest of him is going to be flesh and blood. Oh, hold on. Again. Sorry. Console's playing up. Time for its 2000-year MOT. Osgood thought you should know something else important. That which holds the image of an angel becomes itself an angel. So when Larry took pictures of them on his phone, that's how they were able to infiltrate it. But hey, you dealt with all that, and I think... Hello? Oh, I'm picking up a distress signal from the Bar Galactica, so I best be off. Just one last message from Osgood. She said if you ever fancy working with her again, well, all you've got to do is pick up the phone. Literally. Oh, about Larry, my old friend. I really hope he's going to be happy as, well, happy as Larry. But I'm not sure what happens to him next. I don't know everything. Where'd be the fun in that? See ya.